Hello and welcome to Friday Double Bill, the show where we review and analyze the latest films from Bollywood and Hollywood to help you make a more informed choice at the movies. Today we've got a whopper of a show, and to tell you more about it, here's Mayank Shekhar.
Well, it's a huge weekend at the theaters, as it turns out, and we've tinkered with the format of the show just a little bit. Between us, me and Fahad, we watched 5 movies this weekend, but then 3 have been done by me, 2 have been done by him, which means we're looking at Friday Double Bill, of course, but we're also looking at Triple Quick Takes. Well, so far as the big reviews are concerned, we're coming up right away with the review and a discussion on Action Jackson. That's the big Bollywood release. And from Hollywood, there's Ridley Scott's Exodus, Gods and Kings. Action Jackson, or AJ, is a film directed by Prabhu Deva. It is about a young man played by Ajay Devgn, who without much reason or warning starts getting attacked by various goons in his city. Clearly, there is a mystery behind this occurrence. Revealing anything beyond this would be giving the movie away. But here's what we can tell you. There's Ajay Devgn in possibly every scene in this film. Women love him. Even the villain loves him. He can kick ass. He can wield the sword. But for what? As in, what is the story of this film? Ah, that doesn't matter.
You know, Mayank, every once in a while, there comes along a movie of such epic proportion where everybody is humbled and silenced and stunned. This was one such film. It began with Sonakshi Sinha, how do I put this delicately, being constantly exposed to Ajay Devgan's nether regions. She is so overwhelmed by what is on display that she feels that this brings her good luck. So she has made it now her mission to constantly get a glimpse of his dangling dong. And the film unfolds on that level and that premise. And then it's just downhill from there all the way, is it not?
You know, I'll be very, very honest with you, Fahad. I was extremely late for the show. I was stuck in a traffic jam. Bombay, you know, you can be in a traffic jam for about 2 hours. That's roughly what was going on with me. I didn't anticipate it, which is already a physical assault on your senses. Then I land up in the theater, and then I come across what is supposed to be escapist entertainment. But that is such a, you know, assault on my mental senses that I really lost it. I thought I was better off being in that jam. To cut a very long story short, Fahad, there are certain films that should not be dignified with review, and it happens once every few weeks. This is one of those films, and you know, I'll withhold my review only for the fact that this is not a film.
Correct. Now, you're talking about escapist entertainment. This was a bunch of critics being held captive in a cinema hall, wanting to escape, but unfortunately, they didn't have that prerogative. This is singularly the worst film I have ever seen in my life, which is saying a lot given the kind of crap we've been subjected to on a, you know, weekly sustained basis. You've got Sonakshi Sinha and her thunder thighs, God bless them. You've got Yami Gautam serenading Ajay Devgan. You've got Manasvi Mamagai, who has embraced this role with a passion. And you know, is a vamp of really some amazing consequence, obsessed with Ajay Devgan, and would, you know, kill, maim, murder, loot, pillage, do all that she has to do. it's probably the worst experience one has ever had to sit through. And I agree with you, this is not even a film that we can review. All we can do is commiserate with each other. We've just come from this film, by the way, so we're still reeling in shock.
We're just getting to the details, and I think calling something the worst, that means the first from below, is high praise to begin with. Let's get into details. Let's get on to the oh my god or the OMG moments from this film.
Given that this film is probably the worst film one has ever had the misfortune of watching, it's just a series of nuggets of oh my god moments. Kunal Roy Kapoor has hammed so outrageously in this film. You know, it's hard to believe that anybody could be this third rate in a film in terms of acting, over the top performances. Everything is so slapstick or crude. This obsession with the male member, you know, with women, the reactionary, sexist, misogynistic movie. borrowing heavily and unapologetically from Kill Bill, from Sin City, just lifted violently all kinds of things and still makes such a huge mess of things.
Well, you know, I was looking for an oh my god moment to come from you, and I realized that you've already given your oh my god moment, which was from the first half of the film where you mentioned Sonakshi Sinha's character. I think there is a curious piece of writing going on here, so far as the female characters are concerned.
There's curious piece of writhing, because this is a Prabhu Deva film. Everybody is writhing, they are cavorting, they are doing all kinds of calisthenics. This is what passes as Prabhu Deva's dancing. God bless him, he's a genius. But when every single person in the film is, you know, dancing like him, and they certainly can't measure up, it is pathetic. Sorry to interrupt.
I'm still on the writing part, and I think the fact that right after the first half of the film comes our villain, or actually the villain's sister, who I thought was, you know, I think it needs to come from some really, you know, higher source of imagination to come up with a character who looks at Ajay Devgn and thereafter, you know, is obsessed with him. The first time that she meets him after having taken a shower thinking about him and smoked a few cigarettes thinking about him, she says, "Tum mujhe jaante nahi ho, jaante nahi ho." And then Ajay Devgn says, "Tum mujhe jaante nahi ho." And you know, this whole obsession with, "I love AJ, I'm obsessed with AJ, I want AJ." And you know, AJ is my little nephew, you know. And I thought to myself, I wish I could change his name.
So if there was any doubt in your mind as a viewer whether we are going to endorse this film as a dekho or a peko, it has got to be the most emphatic peko ever. Mayank.
Well, you know, to be fair, Fahad, what did you expect? Firstly, this is a Prabhu Deva film, which means he made Wanted. After that, with Salman Khan. After that, Akshay Kumar wanted to make his Wanted, so he made Rowdy Rathod for him. Then Shahid Kapoor wanted to make his Wanted, and therefore he made R. Rajkumar for him. And therefore now, Ajay Devgn wants his Wanted, and he has made this movie called Action Jackson, which means a lot of stunt scenes, and then Jackson, which means a lot of dance moves. That's really what heroes in Bollywood are supposed to do. And you know these things anyway, but nothing on planet Earth could have still prepared you for a movie called AJ. I don't know whether we're supposed to endorse it in terms of watching it on TV, or are we doing some endorsing watching on DVD, theater. I think I dare you to watch it anywhere and let us know what you feel.
If you think this is a remake and a remake of Wanted, please take it from us. It's unwanted.
Well, that's it, guys. That was Friday Double Bill for you. Tell us what you thought of the movies. Tell us what you think of the show.